Good afternoon. On this short video clip, we're going to be discussing how to save your images off of PAX. It's very important before you start that you go to PAX, you look at your studies, and you get the appropriate information that you'll need for publication. For example, the patient gender, the patient age. I want to point out here that this study is named Mickey Mouse. This medical record number has been created for Mickey Mouse, so I'm not giving any patient identifying information here. We created this file and renamed it ahead of time. So when you're at your PAX machine and you're selecting your images, you've got the information that you need to write your figure caption, I find it very helpful to select your key images. This particular PAX, we use select images, and then when you go to the internet version of this, you can just click on key images and it'll go straight to the image in question. This particular patient was a 40-year-old male with right lower quadrant pain. It had started at his umbilicus, it had gone down to the right lower quadrant. This is a really classic example of appendicitis that I chose as my key image here. So what you do when you go to PAX, you want to save this image. Well, you'll notice that there's patient identifying information here, in this case Mickey Mouse. Sometimes that writing will overlie the image, and what you can do is get rid of the annotation none. That way, if there's any writing overlying the image, for example the H that used to be up here, it's gone. Then what you want to do in this case is right click and export your image. You want to export it, and the default here is called image.jpg, and it's a JPEG file. The problem with saving an image as a JPEG is that lossy compression occurs. And when you're doing an image for publication, you want to make sure that you use lossless compression. So what you do is you go down to a TIFF file and you save it as a .tiff. And then you want to name your file some way that you'll remember it. And in this case, I'm going to call it APPY1 so that I'll remember that it's my appendicitis case. You want to make sure that you give it a name, APPY1, for example, so that when you use other images, you can call them APPY2 and APPY3. Again, this is a TIFF file. You click Save, and you're done. That's how you get your highest quality image off of PAX.